I don't really need to look at the street. This is the first person on the vlog, guys.
We're gonna try Korean corn dogs. Well, I've already tried it, but I'm guessing this one is a cheese one. I think that's the rice cake one. So, rice cake. This one is the hot dog one with garlic parmesan. Let's see
this. How am I gonna cut this? It's almost thick.
Dude, just bite into it.
Yeah, I was
that's
like,
part of the experience, to bite into it.
It's hot, right?
Yeah. I'm gonna bite into the cheesy one, the mozzarella one. So good. How's that one? I mean, obviously, I can't go wrong with bread and cheese and potatoes.
The garlic parmesan be really
hitting you?
Yeah. Like, garlic. Ha! Ha!
You want to switch?
I'm not tossing tall with you.
Don't start farting in here.
That's
good though. I feel like that could have used some garlic parm.
Yeah. So, switch it up. Put that one in there. And then garlic. It's a stick. Don't stab this stuff. Right?
That was a move. Now it's like an Italian Korean corn dog. Oh, you want to try the rice cake?
I want to try the rice cake.
Okay.
Like, it has rice.
Oh,
it has rice. It has rice in it, right?
Just munching it.
I'm scared.
You didn't like it?
It's not the texture that I thought it would be. It's crunchy and soft, and I'm confused.
It feels like it's like funnel cake inside of like flour.
No, it tastes like a
dough.
Whatchamacallit?
It's like a donut inside.
No, what is it?
Like a bland donut.
It has like almost the consistency of a relleno de papa.
Relleno.
Eso mismo.
Yeah.
Yo, that upset my stomach.
Mm-mm. You had one bite.
And one bite was enough. Why was it squishy?
Just wash it down with something else, bro. Alright. We've tried out Korean corn dogs. I think the cheese one won for Larissa. It's the safest bet.
Yeah.
I like this Rihanna thing.
It's like your Rihanna.
I'm gonna be better, have my money.
I just came back from hanging out all day with my friend Larissa. And one, I am so full. because we had eaten Chick-fil-A before we ate those corn dogs. I'm so, so full. But they were so good. I mean, she didn't really enjoy a lot of them. She's trying her best to try out new things. She's a picky eater, but love her for trying. I'm gonna get unready because I just came, like, literally I've been out since like 8 in the morning and it is now 8 p.m. I'm using the Paula's Choice cleansing balm, double cleanse your skin. I be struggling with my skin. Like, I just have, I'm pretty like acne prone, and then like get dark spots if I pick at my face, and dry patches. Just like the struggle out here, but whatever. This is nice. Like, just come home and decompress. But we were out just running errands all day, and honestly, we hadn't hung out like that since a while. We both started working, and then like it really doesn't hit you how much like your life gets consumed by like work or just other responsibilities, that like the friends that you used to hang out with like day and night. It's sad, we're old ladies now. I'm blind right now. Anyways, but it was so necessary. Honestly, we hung out here and there, just stuff like that, but we hadn't had like a real good hangout or like gone to do stuff, like just go to Target together. Like, I enjoy just doing like everyday stuff with like my friends or the people that I'm closest with. Like I'll go with you while you get your nails done, or while you're running errands, or you're going to Target to like get your dog food. Like, that's, I'm a quality time person. Like, I don't know if you guys are familiar with the five love languages, but like, I'm literally just like, I'll be there with you kind of person. Like, we'll be doing nothing and I'm having a good time. Honestly, like, today was a good day. Today was nice. And we just talked about like how we could be, you know, in our new life, still involved in each other's lives, especially because, you know, we go through things and we are like accountability partners. So, you know, like if we have goals, we keep each other accountable. By the way, I was using the CeraVe salicylic acid cleanser. She keeps me from like breaking out. Honestly, like, you wouldn't really think that I am acne prone, but it'd be a struggle. Like, right now I have all these like cluster of little bumps here. That's fine. To some, God gives perfect skin. To some of us, we gotta work for it. But yeah, we were just talking about like anything and everything. Just everything, like family, career, life, events, like, just so that we don't feel like alone in our journeys. Like, you know, like, we go through stuff. Honestly, I'm so glad for the group of friends that I have. That I have mascara still on my eyes. Let's take some eye makeup remover. Use the Neutrogena one. I do tend to just have like few but quality friendships. However, obviously being part of church and part of the body has taken me out of my comfort zone to be more open with more people. But as far as it comes to like people that hold me accountable, I do have like my closer friends. People that I share my dreams with, that I share my struggles with, the people that are gonna encourage me and that kind of know what's going on in my life. You know, but it's very important to open yourself up to that, have accountability, to have like those friends that are really gonna push you toward your goal, and especially push you closer to God. Especially like if your goal is to get closer to God, surround yourself with people that are also trying to get closer to God. Because, you know, you guys are in the same, that same journey. I'm not gonna complicate my life with serums right now. I'm gonna use this vitamin C tonic by Sweet Chef. I got this at Target. Just makes like my skin brighter, because right now she's looking a little dull. But yeah, just accountability partners keep you. They're the ones that check you if they don't see you striving toward those goals, or that check in on you. You know, so I really encourage people to have that. I will say that like it's not always as like easy as like, oh, like they found me kind of stuff. Like I think that when we're little, we kind of make friends with whoever's kind of like around us in proximity, and it's just so like natural. And then as you get older, it's kind of harder to have friendships and to like keep friendships and build friendships, like pour into a friendship, and just like having people that like you genuinely click with and that like get you, like finding your people. One, I do think that like seeking God and asking him for like those friends is important, and then opening yourself up to trying. When I first met Laritza, I think we were like 19 maybe or 20, and I had just come to Orlando for college, and we met at like the college and career group at church. And honestly, like, we didn't really know each other, but I offered to give her rides home, and we kind of got to know each other then. And even then, like, we just kind of like, we're both very shy because we're both introverted. But I don't know, somehow, like, we tried. We were like, oh, we're around the same age. And just like, do you want to go get coffee? We both happened to be like in a very small group at the time. The college and career group was smaller. We're just like, you know, we want to get closer to God, and we want people that are going to encourage us. So like, let's, without saying it, we were like, let's try to build on this really, like this friendship. We were just like hanging out like as friends, but knowing that, you know, we were trying to build healthy friendships. So that's like, that was the origin story to mine and Laritza's friendship. Then we got way closer when we went on a missionary trip. Stuff that you don't really think about until you're just like, wow, I have poured into like this friendship. And sometimes you do have to be intentional with your friendships. Like, I'm gonna go out of my way because you mean a lot to me. Sometimes it gets hard and you kind of like need a check and like, hey, like, are we doing enough? Like, have we kind of forgotten about each other? Like, we need to be active, like participants in each other's lives, because we go through things and we don't want to leave each other like hanging, but we can get distracted by just like life. And it's just, we're trying to like navigate, you know, like adulthood. We're like trying to figure stuff out. So today was a good like reset on like our friendship. Lurts, if you're watching this, I love you, girl. It's good to have those friendships and to keep in touch with them and to build on them. You know, like as you grow, you might have to be intentional with the relationships that you have, with the accountability partners that you have, but like it's so worth it. Today was actually fun. It wasn't like a task, like, oh, I have to like catch up and I need to talk to somebody. It's like, no, let's go out and like catch up, but like, let's just Let's just do normal stuff. Like, let's just have fun. As a quality time person, I love that.
I spent my whole day pretty much being a couch potato and feeling guilty about it, but like trying not to. I just had some things to absolutely get done during the day, and I got them done, and then I contemplated like going out for a walk, but I just started watching vlogs, and I'll probably end my night just watching one of like my comfort shows. I rewatch the same three shows over and over again, and I just have it playing in the background. I'm not sure if that is just a comfort thing. I just know what's going on, you know, especially in comedies. Except that one episode of Friends. Friends is one of those shows that I rewatch all the time. That one episode when Ross and Rachel break up, like, that was a little bit too emotional for me. I was like, what are you guys doing? I skip over that. Also skip around the things that I don't like, especially the episodes that I've already seen, the ones that give me secondhand embarrassment, which Gossip Girl does that a lot too.